Hello all, and welcome to my new video. I'm playing two games against Zach. I will try to edit them so we can see both of them after each other. I know Zach always starts with two buggies and a grenadier, so I thought let's try starting with an Athena and a grenadier to counter his setup. Well, here we see what's gonna happen. His units will try to take the middle, and I've decided to use my Athena to counter his buggy and even the grenadier. he spawns in a jet fighter, sky fighter, to counter my Athena. That's why my sky fighter will cover it. And the buggies are there to fill up my space. As you can see, my Athena has killed two units already and is now ready to kill the third. And this is, I think, a nice time to start about auto-aim. A lot of people in my alliance hate the auto-aim feature and they don't use it. I use auto-aim on almost all my units except the Grenadier while trying to maximize its effectiveness, but minimize the negative impact that it sometimes has. Because, like here, you can see my Athena attacked his generator and not his unit. If I wouldn't have had it on auto-aim, I would have made sure the generator wouldn't be hit. Those are the auto-aim problems. But knowing that the auto-aim follows the closest unit or the unit that you target makes it a really good tool to use if you're using it correctly. Here we have the fight in the middle, but slowly I'm winning. I don't want my grenadier to die on the left side, so I disarm the unit over there and spawn in some units to help defend. And that's the win. Well, next battle is up. Welcome back to the next battle against Zach. Like the previous time, I thought, let's use my Athena and Grenadier combo against his. But he has learned and uses a bomber now against my setup. That's how the game is played. You have to really think about what the other player will do. And then try to take advantage of this. As you can see, his bomber will go straight between my pylons. And I think it will be a problem because I don't have enough energy for a sky fighter. So here we go. As you can see, my grenadier, where he goes to, that's normally a spot where I'll stay to keep firing. But this time I'm not gonna use that because I don't want my grenadier to die from his bomber. I got the first antimatter, I think, yes. But it will be at the cost of my pylon. Telling about the auto-aim, look at my sky fighter. I'm not moving him forward anywhere. The only thing that I've done is auto-aim him at the bomber. So whatever way the bomber flies, he will take the direct route against it. That's really a big plus. Here I use my EMP to take out his grenadier, because grenadiers are really good against Athenas, as long as you can keep them a little bit in cover. Two or three hits and your shield is gone, and that's normally what a grenadier gets on the Athena. So he has lost all his units now. I'm trying to save mine by running away from the generator, but I've sacrificed two. Now I used my disarm against this bomber. The reason for that is because I only had two buggies there, and the bomber kills the buggies pretty good. He will lose, but he will take one or two buggies with him, and now he died without killing any. As you can see, my Athena is also auto-aimed on his buggy. And to be honest, it's now just a cleanup. So my Athena is cleaning up the buggies, and the grenadiers are trying to take out the generators, and it will go fast now. So these were two battles against Sekwar. And they went pretty well. Well, have a good day. Bye-bye.